Hello, Asmashita again. I have secured 150 marks in physics in NEET 2021. I wasn't really sure about making this video because these marks are quite a bit less compared to other toppers and even my own mock test scores, which were around 165 or 170. Actually, I had panicked a bit in the examination room because paper was very lengthy and very calculative, but I still managed to somehow solve all the questions. Anyways, this video was very highly recommended and I thought that if my tips can be useful to even some of you guys to navigate your way through physics, then I will be more than happy. Also, I have added some timestamps in the description so that you can jump on to specific parts of the video. With that said, let's dive right in.
I can't think.
Okay, let's admit it. Physics is hard. Maybe a bit less hard for me and a bit more hard for you at this moment, but let me tell you, initially even I had the fear of physics. मतलब कुछ chapters totally दिमाग के ऊपर से चले जाते हैं. The optics part, waves, oscillations, semiconductors ले लो, ये logic gate वो logic gate करते करते पूरा chapter ही खत्म हो जाता है और पता भी नहीं चलता. I totally feel you. But at such times, I used to hold on to this one sentence that I wrote in my diary during my preparation, and I quote, "You can never run away from life. Even if you try to, life will double up its speed and will catch you anyways, so you better face it." I think that this sentence applies to every aspect of our life. No matter how much you try to ignore physics, it will keep haunting you, so why not stick with it and finish it for once? Now that you have decided to get it done, how do you start? Number one, concept clearing. You never leave any chapter undone, no matter how hard it gets. For example, the one chapter that I struggled with the most was semiconductors. I initially did it from the Akash I tutor, but none of the concepts could get through my head, so I went on to YouTube. But to add on to my bad luck, even physics wala hadn't uploaded the lectures. So I approached my local coaching, I requested the teacher to take that chapter. He even started it, but then pandemic happened, the second or the third wave I guess, and the lectures got suspended. Finally, some other teacher uploaded the lectures for that chapter on the online platform of that coaching, and that was when I finally completed my semiconductors. It has been a very long journey, okay? The most convenient thing for me would have been to skip that chapter. But if I hadn't completed it, then I wouldn't have been able to solve that one question which came in the section B of physics in NEET, and that would have costed me my rank by thousands. So my dear friends, you do not leave any chapter and do not go on the way to this, okay? Give your best to each and every chapter. Number two, reference books. I personally solved Akash's modules and PYQs. See, even DC Pandey, SC Verma, Sinkage are way too good, but they contain a lot of information and a huge amount of some really easy or some really hard questions. While Akash's or Alan's material consists of a limited number of questions that cover all the concepts while maintaining a standard equivalent to the NEET paper. But obviously, which reference book to choose is totally up to you. Just make sure that you refer only one book and revise it at least 5 to 6 times. This is a very big issue, okay? Students do not really revise the questions. Many of them would be solving like 1000 questions for one chapter, and agar usi mein se koi question exam mein aa gaya, they'll be like ki ye question kahi dekha dekha sa lag raha hai, but ab theek se yaad nahi ki ise karte kaise. If this happens with you too, my dear, you're doing something really wrong and you need to correct it right away, okay? See, if you're referring DC Pandey, then you should be able to answer any question from that book whenever asked, and that is a must. Now, how do you go about doing that? First of all, make a solution notebook, okay? When you're solving the questions for the first time, write short solutions of all the questions that you were able to solve and mark the questions that you couldn't solve. The next day, go to those marked questions and try to solve them again. This time, you'll be able to solve some of them and some of the questions will get double marked. Okay? Then you can go on to Google, see the solutions, understand them, shut down Google, and then write the solutions on your own. The third time, you do a very quick revise. The most important revision is the fourth revision. This time you'll be able to solve 95% of the questions, but there still will be a 5% that you couldn't solve. And these 5% questions can now be added to your notes. so that every time you revise your chapter notes, you'll be able to revise these questions too. Now, as we know, there are a lot of questions to be done even once. How are we gonna solve them 5 to 6 times? Okay, so here's the trick. You're gonna write the answers to those questions on a paper only for the first 2 times. From the 3rd time, you'll be revising the questions. Now, this means that you're gonna see the question, you're gonna think of all the concepts and the steps to solve it, and once your answer is ready in your mind, you'll look into your solution notebook, see if you did all the things correctly, and if you miss some points and you think that you'll be missing the point even the next time, you know, we know that which point you're gonna forget and which point is fine, okay, we can remember. So if you're gonna forget that point, you can circle that question so that in the 5th and 6th revision, when you don't have a lot of time to invest, you can directly pick those circled questions and you can make sure that all of your weaker areas are covered too. Now the last point is, do we really need to read NCERT for physics? I personally think that NCERT is good, but you do not need to stick to it completely, okay? You can make a quick read once and you can highlight some points and you can revise those highlighted points 2 to 3 times and you'll be done, okay? There's no need to put some extra efforts on NCERT, and I personally think that you should take your NCERT only after you're done with your syllabus completion. All the best. Thank you.